Hola, this is Kathleen and welcome to my channel, Kay the Crafty Planner. Today I want to share with you how I made my monthly cover. This cover is very unique because I got to incorporate my two passions, crafting and planning. I will be using specialty paper by Gina K Designs and gold foil paper from the brand Heidi Swapp, and I will be making a shaker page. If you don't know what that is, stay tuned. To begin, I am cutting my specialty paper to the dimensions that will fit my disc bullet journal. I will also cut the foil paper so it covers the complete design. In order to make the foil stick to your design, you will need heat. Since I don't own a Minc machine, this is the recommended machine to use this paper for, I will be using my laminator. I purchased this laminator a few years ago at Walmart for about $20, and it does about the same job of a Minc machine, but for less money. To make the magic happen, you will need to place the foil on top of your paper with the shiny side face up, just like I'm showing you right here. Make sure that the portion of the design that you want with the foil finished is covered completely. Put it through the laminator and watch the magic happen right before your eyes. You will see that the foil sticks to the design on your paper, leaving that beautiful foil finished. Now it's time to add the shaker element to my paper. The first thing I'm going to create is a window. It is in this window that I will be adding tiny pieces of confetti so they can move around freely, hence our shaker page. To create this window, I will be using a die cut in the form of a heart. I feel it goes well with the love theme of this month. Please note that you don't need die cuts or a die cutting machine to create the window. You can trace any shape you want and cut it out the old-fashioned way. Once I have the window cut out, it's time to add a clear cover. This clear cover functions as the glass of our window, allowing us to see those tiny embellishments when they move around. To make the cover, I will be cutting a piece of a sheet protector that I had in my craft room. I'm going to tape that clear piece to the back of my window, making sure that I cut it a little bigger than my window. In the past, I have used different clear pieces to make my shaker cards. You can use anything you have around, even the clear plastic from an old packaging. My window is now ready. To create the shaker structure, I'm going to use double-sided foam tape and a piece of watercolor paper. This watercolor will be the background of my window. When you see through the window, you will be able to see this background instead of a plain white paper. You can use any paper for this. I would recommend using a paper with a nice pattern. I think it will look beautiful too. I chose watercolor paper because I wanted to use my distress inks. I love the property of these inks and how well they mix. I am using an ink blending tool to color my paper. Once I have the colors I want, I will be spraying this paper with Shimmer Mist. Shimmer Mist is basically water with glitter. Adding this spray to any project makes it sparkle. You can see the glitter well on the video, but in person it looks gorgeous. When these inks come in contact with water, the color moves around. I don't want my colors to move for this project, so I will be dabbing any excess water. You will notice that when I dab the paper to remove the water, it also removes the ink. These inks are great for making galaxy scenes. To create the wiggle room for my embellishments to move, I will be adding some double-sided foam tape. This tape has some dimension to it, and it will give us the height we need to allow for those tiny pieces to move. Using my foam tape, I'm going to create a border around my window, making sure that I don't leave any spaces open because this border will contain all the embellishments within the window. As I'm placing the foam tape around my shape, I make sure not to place the tape too close to the edge of my window. I don't want my tape to show through. A tip to make the double-sided foam tape more manageable is to remove the backing. This will allow you to mold the tape to your shape. Once the double-sided foam tape is in place, it's time to add the embellishments. I am using this container from Michaels, which has tiny cutouts of hearts and stars. I thought they went well with the theme, so I'm using it. Once the desired amount of embellishments is placed in my window, I'm going to add the watercolor paper on top. Since the border is double-sided, your background piece will stay put. I also like to add scotch tape to the four sides of the background paper just for reinforcement. That way, I am certain that the tiny embellishments are staying in the window and not all over my bullet journal. Now you can see the tiny pieces moving around in my window. To cover the back of my shaker page, I am going to tape the monthly calendar to the back. Many bullet journal users don't really use a full monthly calendar because they already have a monthly log and a future log. I like to see the whole month at a glance, so I created this monthly calendar in my computer. I cut it out to the dimensions for my paper and I taped it to the back. Now, my shaker page has a clean look. To finish my shaker page, I'm going to add the name of the month. For this, I am using the help of my stamps. I used gold embossing powder to bring the look together. I am stamping the word with VersaMark ink, adding gold embossing powder, and then heating the embossing powders with my heat tool, creating this gold embossed look. I am cutting the paper to about half an inch and then taping it to my cover to finish my monthly cover. And here you have it, my gold foil shaker page. I really love how this monthly cover turned out. I hope you have enjoyed this video. And if so, please give it a thumbs up and remember to subscribe. Please follow me as I craft, plan, and do other life-giving things. And remember, it is never too late to create something new. So start today. Hasta luego.